It's early February here in central London. We're at the Science Museum for something a little bit different. On display is a set of Cal Foggy 11s from the 90s when he raced with Castrol Honda. They've been here since the 90s and we're going to replace them with a suit of Valentino Rossi from last year, 2015. I picked up the suit in Dainese headquarters in Italy, just outside Venice. We brought them over to the museum. We're going to get them on display. So when next time visitors come to the museum, they get to see the latest leathers from Dainese, the full airbag AirTech leathers. So we're here in the bowels of the Science Museum here in London, and what we're doing is changing Foggy's old Dainese suit for Valentino's Rossi suit from 2015. We've had the suit here on display since the 90s, if you remember when Foggy rode for the Castrol Honda. This was a 100 mile an hour crash, and as you can see, it's starting to look a bit dated, but it did its purpose. It kept Foggy in one piece, and he went on to win more world championships. We've also got his boots, if you remember the old Dainese boots that went on the outside of the leathers. And we've also got the old Dainese gloves with the Kevlar. And these were made to measure for Foggy in the day. The reason for the gloves is that these are property of the museum, so they're going to go into the archives, and they'll be here maybe in 10, 15, 20, or even 30 years from now. And then we're going to move on to the Rossi suit that we're going to get installed in the museum, so when you guys come to the museum, you'll be able to see the new Rossi suit. So this is the suit that's going to replace the old Foggy suit from his Castrol days. This is 2015 Dainese Valentino suit, and this is the actual suit that Valentino wore. You can see some of the scrape marks from when he had a little tumble. So this is modern kangaroo skin, titanium shoulders, full airbag, Deere technology. It just really shows how much leathers have come along since the old Foggy days. Beforehand, it was all about body armour and just keeping the rider from losing skin and breaking limbs. Now it's all about pre-prevention. So the airbag's going to activate before Valentino hits the ground, and it's saving collarbones, saving ribs, saving vital organs. Dainese have had, I think, over 500 now deployments of the airbag and one broken collarbone in MotoGP and World Supers, which is a phenomenal kind of stat if you think about it. That's 500 big, big crashes and one broken collarbone. So this is going to go up to the museum, which we're going to show you in a few moments, and we'll get it on display and we'll get the airbag lit up. Okay, so we've got Valentino's suit stored, secure, and for everybody to see. It's great to see kind of modern technology and Valentino here in the Science Museum. It's quite a little proud moment. I'm quite pleased, really. We've brought the leathers all the way over from Italy, all the way from the Dainese factory. We'll be on show here now for as long as the Foggy ones, and they have been here since, what, 96, 95? So who's going to know what's going to happen in 10, 15 years' time, and who's going to replace Valentino in 10 to 15 years?